Hello, everybody. My name is Helen Thompson. I'm head of franchise support at the British Franchise Association. And in readiness for our Empowering Women in Business event, which is happening in October, I'm here today talking to Shafali Shone-Keen, who is a McDonald's franchisee. And McDonald's are our sponsors of our EWIB event this year. Hi, Shafali. How are you doing today?
Very well, thank you. Very happy to be here. Thank you.
Really lovely to meet you. Really lovely to meet you. So, Shafali, tell us a little bit about you and your journey to becoming a McDonald's franchisee.
So, I'm married. I've got two kids. And I've had a successful career in banking and corporate finance for an engineering business. And I spent many years in the corporate world and absolutely loved it. But I think as I was approaching 40, I kept thinking I want to do more for myself, more for my family, you know, more for others around me. And I felt like I could also give more. So it kind of hit me then that if I don't do anything about it now, I'm never going to do it. And my parents had a business for 30 years in West London. Mm-hmm. Seen my dad and his journey through having his own business and how much he enjoyed it. And yes, it was hard work, but he felt really satisfied and fulfilled from it. Mm. And I had that same feeling. And I thought, you know, as a parent and as a mother, you also want that flexibility in your work and to be a role model to your children. I've got one girl and one boy. And I think it's both really important for them to see, you know, mummy being as successful as daddy. So this is when one evening I was talking to my father and he said, you know, why don't you consider the McDonald's franchise? And I thought, okay, I hadn't really thought about that because I thought about lots of other business ideas, but nothing quite stacked up or warranted me leaving my current role.
Yeah.
Not until I came across McDonald's and franchising. And I just instantly fell in love with it, with everything about it. And I became this sort of obsessive girlfriend that had to like nab this guy to be my husband. But it just made sense. As you know, for any woman, any entrepreneur, anybody looking to run their own business, it's a business, you know, McDonald's is a business that gives you sort of the freedom to have your own business, but within their framework.
Yeah.
And you're more likely, you know, in my eyes, to be successful with a company like McDonald's than you are on your own. Yeah. And I've seen that, you know, firsthand through this, you know, this past 18 months while I've had my training through the pandemic, just how it's always been at the forefront. It's kind of first, it's put people first. And this is what I'm about as well as an individual. So they're as resilient now as they have been, you know, 30 years. It's a business that's grown year on year. And it's a business that's weathered what's happened this past, you know, 2 years, 18 months, and
absolutely
come out even more successful. So with this in mind, you know, I decided to apply, never ever thinking I would get through. I went to an open day and I dragged my husband and my dad with me. So my dad, just from a from a business and financial perspective, like, does this make sense? And my husband, because he needs to support me in this.
Absolutely.
Of course. It made complete sense to me to do it. So I applied. That was back in 2019 now. I applied and answered the various questions of the application form. And then within 2 weeks, I got an email from McDonald's saying been successful and asking me to come in for an interview. And it was great. It was a great experience. And the whole interview process took about 6 months, very reflective on, you know, is it the right decision for them? But also, is it the right decision for me? Because it's a marriage, really, because it's a 20-year marriage.
Yeah, indeed.
So you have to make sure that, you know, the courting bit, you know, is right for the both of you before you sign up to it. So it's great. I got to meet loads of people from the business. And this is what's very good about McDonald's. They're very transparent in what they are and what they're trying to do and who their franchisees are and how the business is run. So I was able to meet loads of franchisees and have one-to-one conversations with them. I got to go to Liverpool and work in a restaurant for 5 days.
Wow.
Loads of fun. And you're a crew member, basically, just working in the restaurant. And they want to see, look, are you able to do this? And it's good for you to see, like, actually, can I work in a restaurant 20 years and be with these people. And yes, it's fun. It's very humbling because you're with normal people, and it's very different to the corporate world where you're with other people. But you're with everyday people. I'm with like mums, I'm with dads, I'm with college students, university students.
Sure, yeah.
It's really varied. So I think with that in mind, each stage I went through, I just felt, okay, I can do this. This is me. I want to do this. So yes, I was successful. I found out in October 2019, and then I started my training in January 2020.
Wow.
Before lockdown. So that was good. I had 9 months of training. 6 months during lockdown when we were closed.
Gosh.
Yes. And then the remaining part, in the restaurant. And then I got my first store back in April this year.
Wow. So you're at the early stages. So where is your business now? Have you just got the one store
with
McDonald's now? Yeah.
And it's 10 minutes from home, which is brilliant. So with me and my mummy hat on, school, come into work, I'm there, and then, I'm home in the evenings for them. And if I need to pop back 10 minutes away that I can, if my daughter's got taekwondo, I'll go pick her up and then come back to work. And then, for me, really well.
Lovely.
Yes.
It's great that you've got that sort of lifestyle balance. And like you say, it's important, you are a mum, and, that's a great, I suppose, role model for your daughter to see that, you can have everything. You can be a mum, but you can also, be a successful businesswoman at the same time.
Yeah. And also for my son to see as well that,
absolutely,
one day he might marry a woman who's ambitious and do something, and, he's going to be supportive of it. So, yes.
Perfect. So Shafali, just tell me, throughout your career, because obviously you've been in corporate banking, and this is quite a difference for you. Like you said, it's still very, business orientated, but it's quite different for you. But as you've, been through your career and your life in general, have there been sort of strong women that you've had around you or that you've worked with that really influenced you?
Yes. So interestingly, both my grandmothers lost their husbands from an early age. Mm. And one was didn't have anything, and when her husband passed away, she had three sons, and she moved from India and said, I'm going to move to Britain because of the good education that they can provide them. So in the 60s she basically left all her comfort, family, and came here because she wanted to give a good education for her children.
Amazing.
And first, they came in the 60s, they had absolutely nothing, they lived in one room. She got a job screwing toothpaste screw like lids onto toothpaste years, just so that she could be there. And then she kind of worked her way up. And then I look at my father and his two brothers and what they've achieved, it's all down to her and the values that she gave them. And then I've got my mother's mother, who completely different, Oxford education. Read English at I think it was Somerville College, but then lost her husband at a very young age. But she was very accomplished in everything she did. Mm. She was a good player, she sailed, she very highly intelligent, kind of ahead of her times. And I sort of looked at them and what they were doing and how they put themselves forward and survived and were different and unique in their own way. And that sort of gave me the inspiration. And from a really young age, because of their situation, it always taught me to be independent and financially independent. So it's very interesting, I talked to my husband and, we're in a marriage, but I'm also my own person. And my own money. And I decide what to do with my money, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
So I had those two that really kind of pushed me and made sure that I could fill my potential and didn't feel that I shouldn't.
Yeah, They are incredibly, you know, inspiring women for you to have had around and, you know, to sort of carry those stories on. And the fact that they've given you that sort of feeling that that's how you want to, you know, go forward and be strong and independent in your own right, which is amazing. So one last question, Shafali, before we go. If you had one sort of piece of wisdom or advice to offer any women who are thinking, you know, I might start up my own business or, you know, look into franchising as a whole, what advice would you give them?
So interesting. So I know it sounds really silly, but I always questioned myself and my ability as something I could do and whether I'd be good at it. And throughout the whole interview process, I don't think I've ever been so nervous about anything and wanting something so much. But I think it was just before my first interview, and I was doing a sponsored run with a friend of mine, and she knew that I hadn't told many people that I was applying, and I had told her, and she looked at me and she goes, "You got this." She goes, "If you don't believe in yourself, nobody believe in you." And I don't know, she goes, "I don't know why you need to be worrying about it, because I can look at you exactly. I know that they're going to love you and they're going to want to work with you." So it's just, I think it's really important just for people to believe in themselves and have faith in themselves, because if it's the right thing, it will happen. And I think it's, I don't know if I'm being a bit sexist, but I feel when I talk to girlfriends, I feel women so often so kind of like question themselves about whether they can do it, and they don't always have to do it. But I can do it, and I can sit here and I can have a restaurant with 100 people and, you know, have a turnover of $4.5 million a year. You know, they can, you know, you can do it. You just gotta have yourself and just put yourself forward, because it's so much easier to try something and fail than not try at all. And I can recognize myself that during this, I said, if nothing happens, that's fine, but at least I've tried and I'm learning. If this doesn't work out, something else will. Because so much from this experience. So yes, just have faith in yourself, because if you don't, nobody else will. And try it. Lose.
Fantastic piece of advice. I think you're absolutely right. The key thing is that self-belief, isn't it? And that really, you know, pushing yourself, perhaps sometimes out of your comfort areas as well. But self-belief is absolutely key. Shafali, it's been an absolute pleasure chatting to you today. Thank you so much. And I wish you absolutely all the best with your continuing journey with McDonald's. And thank you very much for chatting with us today.
Cool. Thank you very much.
Pleasure. Take good care.